Everybody have their stuff, courtesy of Dwayne Subway. All right, help you file in. Welcome to the March member meeting for the Cottage Grove Chamber. I'm Mike Millich, president of the chamber. A couple guests here, I'd like to welcome them as well. People from the public interested in what we're doing today. A little bit different meeting for us today. We're obviously at Village Hall. I'd like to thank the village staff for welcoming us here today. We're going to start the day off by a little bit of an economic update from Matt Easy and Aaron Ruth on what's going on in Cottage Grove, what's going on in the future, and what's going on this past year. So very excited to hear from them. Then afterwards, we're going to be hearing from most of the candidates for village board positions, and we'll introduce them after Matt and Aaron are done with their brief. And they'll be telling us a little bit about their ideas, a little bit about what they see in the business community going forward as well, telling us a little bit about themselves. So great opportunity. I'd like to thank all them for taking time out of their day to talk to us as well. Real quick, we're not doing member introductions today due to time, but I would like Rennell just to talk real quick about the golf outing, which is coming up May 28th, correct? Okay, Rennell.
May 28th, scholarship, benefit scholarship for Monona Grove High School students. This has been a huge success for us in the past years. We're looking to build on that this year. I have preliminary flyers here. So register early. We've had a lot of response to this, and it's a growing event. So we expect a lot of demand this year, and we'd love to see all of the people that have been involved in the past be involved in the future. A little bit different formatting on this year to hopefully make it a little bit more clear. If you can come and golf, fabulous. If you can't, like to donate something, we've tried to make that a little clearer and more specific so that it's obvious on here how you can participate. We can take it any level, as small as a gift basket, all the way up to large sponsors. So I will be emailing these as soon as they're complete, so you'll have it in an email form, and then we'll also have hard copies available if you'd like to grab some. Steve, do you want to add anything? Okay, thank you.
A lot of new things this year that they're doing. Really excited about it as well. So, all right, so today, informational session for all of us here. Everybody here is connected in the business community in some way. I think it's very important for us to be aware of what's going on. We have an economic development committee as well within the chamber. Most of you know that, and we're involved in promoting our interests as business and communicating with the village board what we see as being important to our businesses here in town and to future businesses who are hopefully looking to come to Cottage Grove. So without further ado, I'll bring up Matt and Aaron, and they can give us a little update, and we appreciate you guys. Yeah. Thanks,
Mike.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for coming out. A handful of you have already seen most of this presentation. We've done a little bit of a update to it since then. About a month and a half ago, Aaron and I gave this presentation at a village board meeting. It's still relevant today. There are copies floating around of the presentation if you'd like one, and there aren't. Looks like they've been taken up by now, so we can get you some. Just ask us. So just kind of starting out here, we have a few construction projects that will be that are in progress and some that will be coming up soon. Steel Corporation, many of you have heard, and I'll touch on these a little bit later. The UW Clinic, there's an existing one, and it's going to be expanding about threefold directly east of the new Stop and Go on N, or the newer Stop and Go. The Artisan Square Apartments across from the post office, and there's also a just in the design phase right now, but an Arrowwood memory care facility that would be located north of Astor is in the design phase right now. Some expansions and additions. Stantec, it's an environmental consulting company. They're located in the Commerce Park, and they're planning, they have an approved 4,000 square foot expansion. They hope to get started on that soon. Hydrite, they have some site improvements to their spill containment system. Their capacity for spills will will increase to 36,000 gallons. And the Landmark Grain Loading Facility, which is down off of Clark Street, they have done some upgrades to their grain elevator and storage down there. And then a couple subdivisions, as you're aware of, the Westlawn 4th Edition, which is north of Glacial Drumlin Middle School, that will eventually be 85 single-family homes. The finished value of that when it's complete will be about $34 million of tax base. Coyle Highlands South has a mix of office and retail along the commercial corridor to BB. There's also the 50-unit Artisan Square facility, and then 32 residential homes. The residential homes, once complete, there's an additional phase yet to that development. When complete, that will be about $13 million in tax base. The steel facility, they're planning on beginning construction this next month. It's about a 65,000 square foot facility, projecting about a $5 million value. 25 employees coming to the area. This is a facility that they are combining the operations from northern Wisconsin in Hayward and Peoria, Illinois. And we're very excited about them coming to town. UW Clinic, they also hope to begin here this spring.
I think they've started.
Started, all right. They've started. $3.5 million projected value. They are increasing their staff, 10 to 11 of staff and providers, adding two or three new providers as well. It's about three times the current facility, and they plan to get that facility on their current location, plan to get that on the market soon. Artisan Square Apartments, 50-unit apartment complex. They have studio options, one bedroom, two bedroom. The rents range from $850 for a studio up to, for the two bedroom, about $1,400 a month. And the projected value for that facility, about $4.2 million. And they are nearing completion at this time. The Arrowwood Memory Care Facility that we mentioned is a two-story building. It should have about 24 units in it. And the plans are to go through the plan commission. They're hoping to have that ready for us this next month. And we did have a staff meeting with their engineer and the owners this week, and they're excited to move forward. We have actually a couple existing businesses looking to either relocate and or expand, and Aaron and I are working with them on fulfilling those needs. Both would most likely be in the Commerce Park. Across the street from us here, directly south, is a 27-acre parcel owned by BMO Harris. And Aaron, while he was a consultant with Grafe, worked with the village on developing a downtown plan. And Aaron can briefly touch on what that would consist of. This is kind of what the village would prefer to see there. Aaron can talk about that.
Sure, just real briefly, we're envisioning something similar to the Cannery Square and Sun Prairie. There's a block in downtown DeForest that was recently redeveloped with some multi-story, multi-family with some retailer office as well. So that's the kind of development we'd be looking for in that area.
And we're hopeful that we're getting closer to landing a hotel, most likely north of the interstate is the proposed location, just west of the Park and Ride, 11-acre parcel owned by Houston Vekin. and village staff once they get closer. We haven't met with them as of yet, but we hope that time is near. Shady Grove annexation is currently in progress. It would end up being, at least proposed right now, a mix between, there's a multifamily, one multifamily unit, a couple commercial parcels, and then approximately 50 single-family houses, and that's just in the very early stages right now. And then as mentioned, both Coil North and South, near the post office and near the Artisan Square, we are working for, on the south end of the street would be smaller office, retail type uses, and on the north side, restaurants and commercial offices and uses such as that.
Another initiative, we're just getting started here in the village. We created the CDA, Community Development Authority, last year. We appointed our members earlier this year, and they actually have their first meeting tonight. That was scheduled before there was a Badger game, but all the members are so dedicated, they're coming out tonight anyway. The responsibilities and duties of a CDA are all defined by state statute. I won't go through all of them, but basically they're looking at job creation, business expansion, redevelopment opportunities within the village. When we talk to other municipalities about their experiences getting a CDA started and operating them, the thing we always heard was they're only as good as their members. So we were very excited to get the group that we have here. By statute, you have to have two members of your local government, in this case the village board. The other five have to be residents with experience in development or related endeavors. So we're very happy with the group we have. There's a variety of experiences there, also local, regional, and state level perspectives. So it should be a good group. Some long-term development issues that we're looking at. Talked a little bit about the land north of the freeway as a possible hotel site. The village also annexed about another 200 acres to the north of the freeway in 2010. Eventually that'll have to be brought into the urban service area, but the landowners up there do seem to be gaining momentum in the conversations they're having with interested developers. We've had some utility system upgrades recently. The new water tower is certainly an obvious one. Also, there were some improvements to the well up in the Commerce Park. The next sort of major endeavor would be a new water main that would go down Gaston Road to the west, and that would allow additional development in the northwestern portion of the village. Some of this expansion would entail the village getting urban service area expansions from CARPSE. Right now, the village is over its limit, so that may mean we have to exchange some of our existing area to create new areas. But we'll take that as development opportunities come along. There are also some transportation studies going on at the DOT that impact the village. One, they're looking at the Beltline. And then there's another one that's going on right now for I-39, 90-94, which includes 94 out to 73 past the village. So I'm sure all of us in the room benefit from that system. They do have a survey online that they would like responses for through the end of the month. There's a link there. We also have the link on our homepage. So if you have 5-10 minutes in the next week or so, I'd encourage all of you to check that out. And then, of course, we always keep working on the Commerce Park. Rudebush Development and Real Estate are our partners out there. They're our commercial broker for the park. This is a diagram of the land that's still available. It's about 25 acres that are village-owned, about 11 acres that are owned by Landmark. McAllen Properties owns about 5 acres that are open for development.
Which lot is steel going into?
Sure, I can show you there. It's down in the southeast corner.
As you can see, there aren't many large parcels remaining. So you know, now it comes down to finding the right fit, the right use for some smaller parcels. So it's a little bit of a a puzzle at this point.
Are the yellow ones available?
Yes.
Yes.
These are commercial corridors, the ones in green.
Environmental
corridors. Yeah, sorry, commercial. and the lighter colored are available. And these are owned by Landmark.
So what?
It's right here. Yeah.
So with the steel purchase, we're a little bit more than halfway developed in the park.
Could you combine any of those? If somebody came and said we need a larger spot, sure.
And this one specifically, what we would allow it to be split up as needed.
So you have plans?
Yes.
Yeah. Just a quick recap on some of the activities we've done this year. Lots of marketing packets that have gone out to businesses, developers, a couple dozen contacts at least from businesses, brokers. We've sent out invitations for retention meetings and conducted some of those. We've had meetings with the WEDC, gone to different workshops and summits. Put together a database of all the businesses in the village. There are about 177. And we have started collaborating a little bit with Mike and the Economic Development Committee that you guys have at the chamber. One more slide. Some things that you can help. We'd like to do another round of retention meetings, so if you're interested in talking to us, my information's on our website. You can ask me for a card afterwards. Another thing you can do is just pay attention when you're talking to colleagues, friends, family. You have contacts all over Madison, all over the state. Just keep an ear out for opportunities that could relate to the village. And if you have any leads, pass them on. We have marketing materials we can send to you to pass out or just send them our way. And then we're excited that you guys formed your Economic Development Committee. We look forward to working with them, and we'd encourage you to keep supporting that. If you have any questions, we're happy to take them. Otherwise, I know there's lots of other good stuff to get to today.
Do you guys work with the town to develop some of this stuff or not?
With the...
partner with the town to...
The marketing materials, that kind of thing?
Well, just on economic development.
We haven't as much. They're a little more preservation-oriented.
Towns generally don't develop much because they don't have the utility infrastructure. So generally what will happen is we'll be approached by a commercial entity that is interested in town land, but they prefer to annex so they can have access to the village utilities.
Sometimes if we're approached by a business that's just not a fit for the village, we could pass them on. There's a small business park in the town of Sun Prairie off of TT. The town of Cottage Grove has some land closer to 12 and 18, so we could.
There may be certain uses that would be better suited per our zoning, not in the village. So when we get those inquiries, we certainly pass those on to the town. Mm-hmm. Any other questions?
All right. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Minute and
sounds good. All right, so the next part is going to be about half an hour. We have a few minutes. Just wanted to touch on a couple of things that they talked about in our Economic Development Committee. Why was that formed in the chamber and why is it important? The village plans a written document on the village website, and in it, it talks a little bit about where all the tax money comes in Cottage Grove. Right now, as when that was published, 2010, it was right around 80% derived from residential property taxes, about 20% comes from business. It's important for us to support new business coming in because it helps balance that tax basis discrepancy a little bit. It keeps cost of living down, it keeps people living here, it keeps them going to Subway, Piggly Wiggly, that type of thing. The other thing I wanted to touch on real briefly is the hotel. I've had a lot of companies as our members come to me and say that's a very critical part of our business thriving in Cottage Grove. One of the things a developer told me about what is the primary reason they would build a hotel in here are the rugby fields out on Biles Road. in their study, that was the number one key usage of a hotel coming to town. So later this year, I'm going to ask Bob Buchanan to come and talk to us about what they're doing out there and some of their proposals. And the Economic Development Committee views that as critical to Cottage Grove, and we greatly support their efforts. And if you are anybody's interested in being on the Economic Development Committee, talk to me. I chair it. A lot of exciting things going on. Good partnerships with the village, with Matt and Aaron. The other thing we do, too, is if a business comes to town to talk with Matt and Aaron about possibly coming here, the Chamber has sponsored a lunch over at Gaston School Grounds where they will go and they can use a gift card that was provided by us with a welcome packet just to be welcome to Cottage Grove and have a meal. And it's a way that we can support businesses coming here. So,
hey, Mike?
Yeah?
We bring in over 40 events a year, and I get questions on motel every time. So don't forget.
Yeah. So, you know,
that's almost more than the rugby does.
Right. Well, there you go, too. Dave's another one. So, you know, there's a great need for that here, and it's something that we see as being critical to our business success of you guys. So. All right, we're going to get to our next portion of the program. It should last about 30 minutes. I'm going to introduce the candidates. The way this is going to work is this is strictly for our information. It is not a debate. Every candidate was provided with three questions prior to the meeting today, I think about a week prior through email. They're all the same questions. Each candidate will have the opportunity to respond. 2 minutes will be the time allowed. We have a couple people that are assisting us. Phyllis is going to be our official timer, and she from what I've been told, she's a veteran at this, so this should run very smoothly. And then Ronell will be asking the questions, and she's also very good at asking questions, so we're well prepared. A couple of candidates were unable to attend today due to prior conflicts. Pat Mackesy, who's running for village president, Troy Allen, and John Williams. John Williams did provide responses to the questions that he wrote out, so at the end, Ronell will be reading those once we're all done. So, I'll just introduce the candidates briefly, and then Ronell will start with the questions. So, we have Rebecca Nienke, Kyle Broom, Jennifer Pickle, Alex J, and Harvey Potter. So on behalf of the Chamber, we just want to thank you guys for giving your time today to come talk with us. We're very excited about what's going on in Cottage Grove and excited to hear from you. So without that, we're done.
Excellent. So the first question that was mailed out has to do with, tell us a little bit about yourself, your background, where you live, job, family, interests, et cetera. So just give us a little bit of feel of who you are and what you're all about. Do we want to start with Harvey?
First of all, thank you all for being here. I was born and raised in western Wisconsin in a little village called Lafarge along the Kickapoo River. Went to college at UW-La Crosse, have a degree in business administration. After graduation, I spent 2 years as a field artillery officer in the U.S. Army. And after that, I spent a year out in Oregon in graduate school. Came back to Lafarge, taught school, high school there for 2 years, and then have experience as a bookkeeper for an automobile dealership. And then one tax season, I worked for H&R Block. And that right after that, I found my first job in this area with the University of Wisconsin. I worked for the university for 3 years, moved to the Office of the Commissioner of Insurance, was there for 3 years. My oldest son was born in May. I was due to go on the road in the middle of June, and luckily a transfer opportunity came up that allowed me to stay at home, and that position was an auditor with the State Comptroller's Office and the Department of Administration. There we audited state agencies for compliance with the rules, the statutes, and other directives that they're expected to follow. Moved to Cottage Grove when my oldest son was entering kindergarten, so I've lived here now for about 22 years. I've seen a lot of changes in the community since I've been here. It's a great opportunity for going forward. I look forward to that opportunity. When time permits, I enjoy spending time with my extended family. I'm the youngest of eight, so I have a large extended family. I like to see all Wisconsin sports teams do well, but I can't watch them because I get too tense. In retirement, a couple things I hope to do is to travel to places that I haven't been, mainly here in the U.S. And then also, I love to read, and I'd like to take the opportunity to help others by tutoring.
All right.
Your turn.
Takes me 2 minutes to get through my name, so I'll just say thank you. I'm Alex J. Alex Justician is the proper pronunciation. I'm a degreed electrical engineer from Drexel University, certified project manager. I'm also trained in Lean Six Sigma. I work in Stoughton for a pharmaceutical company. I'm a leader in the company. We've worked to double our sales in the past 2 years. We're looking to increase that doubling effect this year. That's going to require investments in Wisconsin. We also created jobs here in Wisconsin as well. I'm interested in basically personal growth, believe it or not, retirement planning. I heard that you should start early, and social activities here in Wisconsin. I think it's a great place to do a lot of activities and a lot of things. And that's keeping it short.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Pickle. I am from Lancaster, Wisconsin, and my husband and I moved here when our daughter was 6 months old in April of 1998, so she's working on 18. So we've been here 18 years. We own a general contracting company together, my husband and I, building homes. I went to school, I have a degree in paralegal studies with an emphasis in business from Winona State University. And we have two children here. Our daughter is a junior at MG, just got her first letter last night in basketball. And our son is in eighth grade at Glacial Drumlin School. I have been involved in this community in basically through my children for many years. PTO president, many years of being on the board in the PTO, and then transferred that over into, I'm a board member for the Monona Grove Education Foundation. We give scholarships, we raise money and give scholarships to teachers. I've been doing that for, I want to say 5 years, I think that's right. So very involved in the community, and we identify with the people here. We have a large group of our friends are here, and we're all about Cottage Grove and Monona Grove.
Kyle Broom. I was born and raised in Jefferson County, Wisconsin, so just over east from here. Graduated Oconomowoc High School and went to MITC Truax, started in business, and then transferred into real estate. I got a real estate degree. While I was in college, I started a real estate and appraisal firm out in Oconomowoc. Worked there for many, many years. Decided that I wanted to move more towards Madison, so my family moved to Lake Mills. Continued operations in Oconomowoc, started to get a little bit more pulled towards Madison, and my wife took a job up in DeForest. So about 2010, we started looking for homes in Cottage Grove. I do real estate, and it took me 7 months to find a home here, so I knew there was a need for real estate for the area. So found our home, moved over in the Tanglewood subdivision off of Vista Drive, which is kind of the road parallel to Wheelbridge. Like I said, I do real estate, appraisal, and consulting. I do some expert witnessing and eminent domain appraisal. So eminent domain appraisal is kind of what got me interested in local politics. I worked on the Highway 26 bypass project in towards the Wiretown area, and then I worked on the roundabout in Oconomowoc when they're getting rid of traffic lights and putting roundabouts into the community. At that time, three local companies bid on the for Wiretown on the bypass project, and one out-of-state company bid on the project, and the out-of-state project or out-of-state company got the bid for the project. So, kind of got me a little concerned about where Wisconsin taxpayer money was going. I'm married for 9 years to my wife Jackie. I have two kids. One is 4 years old, her name's Sadie, just getting ready to go into Taylor Prairie. And then I have an 18-month-year-old son. So my interests are golfing and community events.
Right. Hi, my name is Rebecca Ninke. My husband and I moved here about 10, 11 years ago, and we just bought another house, so we've re-upped our commitment a little bit. I grew up in South Dakota, went to college at Gustavus in Minnesota, grad school in Iowa, and moved to Colorado where I met my husband, and we moved again to Phoenix, Arizona, and when it was time to start a family, we decided to make them grow up cold like we had. So we picked a community, and here we are. We made a very conscious decision to move here and raise our kids here. We have two kids. Kate is just 7, and Reed is almost 13, both in the Monona Grove School District. So one thinks I'm great, and one hates me, and you can kind of figure out who that is. We are in the busy family years, so helping out with different sports. I like to coach, so I've done a little baseball, basketball, tennis, and running activities. My husband works for Dane County Land Information Office. He runs the mapping database there, and he's training for his second Ironman right now, so we don't get to see much of him, which works out pretty well. I'm a half-time Lutheran minister. I have a church in Brooklyn where I work half-time, and I have a small business. I do freelance writing and editing. My undergrad degree was in political science, and I've always had a heart for community politics and international politics. In grad school, I had the opportunity to stay in Namibia for part of a year right after apartheid had ended, and I hope to get back there if I can get a grant to do a sabbatical in the next couple years, if they've just celebrated 25 years. So interesting how some of those things tie in even to local politics, but have been on the board for 2 years, and it's worked out pretty well, and hope to have a chance to do it again.
Wonderful, thank you all. The second question has to do with, why are you running for the village board, and what is your vision for Cottage Grove in the next couple of years?
First off, being a current trustee, I see serving on the village board as a way that I can give back. So I'm continuing that process by endeavoring to step up to village president. For a variety of personal reasons, when my children were younger, there wasn't a lot of opportunity for me to contribute to some of the activities. And so now with my knowledge of government, I just feel like this is where I fit as a participant in giving to the community. And it's an exciting time. You heard the presentation from Matt and Aaron, and it's an exciting time to live and to work and to be part of the government of Cottage Grove. There are many opportunities that await us, and the village has positioned itself well for the future, and we just have to take advantage. We as leaders in the government world, you as leaders in the business world, we need to be able to work together to make the most of the opportunities that lie before us, and I think together we can do that.
Interesting question. What's your vision for Cottage Grove? And currently, I kind of see a lack of vision, lack of direction, lack of goal setting, and lack of goal achievements. I'm running. I've met a few others along the way that share my vision to create a board that leads its committees with visions and goals, ensures the committees are staffed correctly so that they can attain these goals, and ensure that they meet regularly so that they also, to obtain these goals. A lot of times we hear that there's no meetings because they can't get a quorum, but then they probably have the wrong people in those committees. If there's no meeting because there's nothing to discuss, well then we don't actually know what the goals are or how we're supposed to achieve them. A good example is that CDA that was created. It was created in June of 2014. 8 months later, we got members. One of the possible delays is the huge move with the police department dissolution. Big project. But we can't let projects like that, slow down the business growth in Cottage Grove.
Why am I running? I'm ending my fourth year on the board, and I share Harveen's viewpoint. This is an incredible way to be able to give back to the community. It requires an immense amount of time and a lot more time than I even understood when I first ran for this position. but it's incredibly rewarding. My unique look on this is my link with the school district. I believe that the village and the school district should be close partners, and I think that we are, but I think we can do better, and that's where I see my best fit is bringing in that link between the school district and the village. That's why I'm running.
All right, I am running. I guess I'll go back to my Highway 26 story I was talking about, where I got interested in politics. They chose to award the bid to an out-of-state company, use state funds, and that was kind of a pet peeve for me. On a smaller scale, that kind of just happened here with the new police department. Not one general bid on the project from Cottage Grove, and not one subcontractor from Cottage Grove benefited from the work. I know that it's not really controlled by that, but educating local, contractors to and encouraging them to bid on these projects would be important. Kind of my vision for the next 2 years is to kind of educate my neighbors, my locals, clients, just to kind of get them more aware of what's going on. Kind of what Jennifer was just saying, how busy life is and how tough of a job this is. Just to kind of inform those people that can't make it to those meetings and have family things going on is important. I'd also like to kind of reach out and use my real estate contacts to kind of find out what's going on and see if I can help fill up the Commerce Park area. From most of the people I've talked to, the land is very affordable, so I'm just kind of questioning on why that's not filling up faster. Thanks.
Two years ago, we had three seats open and we had one candidate on the ballot, and I had sat on a sustainability committee with Diane, and we talked and she said, you should run. And so I did a write-in campaign and have been on then the last 2 years. It's a pretty good learning curve. You have to kind of be willing to learn about TIFs and CDAs and all the other alphabet words thrown out there. And I come in not always having the answers, but with a willingness to do research and to find out from experts, consultants, what their vision is, and sort of blend that all together to make a good decision. I'm running again because I feel frustrated with some of the other candidates that have, I feel, been spreading rumors and lies and innuendo, and I feel very strongly that we have been a group of people the last 2 years who we work very hard, and we don't always have a consensus in other areas in our lives, but we have been diligent to do research, and I feel that we have worked earnestly and with some grace, I think, together, and strive to do things with a sense of vision for the future. It's hard. Cottage Grove has grown 475%, 475% in the last 25 years. We will continue to grow, obviously, starting so small, not at that same rate. I'm sitting on a committee with Superintendent Olson for the MG schools, looking at the growth and future school planning. These are the kind of issues that Cottage Grove will face, and you all are a part of that in the business community. In some sense, we have a free ride because people keep coming to us, but then we have to balance the amenities that such a small village 25 years ago didn't have with the tax burden today. We would all love a swimming pool and a library and all those types of things, but we have to balance with the tax burden. And I think that we have been diligent on the current board to do that, including the new police department. And stop.
Okay, and the third question is, how will you work with the business community, and what are your priorities for business in Cottage Grove?
This is exciting to see so many of business people here. And what I want to do is I want to remember that the vision of Cottage Grove should be a community vision of Cottage Grove, not my vision necessarily, but a vision of a broader community. And to achieve that is going to require meetings frequently with you folks, with citizens, and that's one of my goals, is to have informal forums, if you will, with citizens so that we can talk about whatever they want to talk about, and then take that vision, take those discussions and bring them to the board so that we can create a consensus of what the vision of the community is. It's really all about community, and it should be the majority of, you know, the people that we try to address. One of the ways that we hope to do that, again, is with the CDA, working together with the chamber to make that happen. You know, we compete regionally for businesses. We aren't alone. Everybody, every community is looking to land businesses, and unfortunately, we don't have as many of the resources to offer, and so we have to address what we do have. And we do have a great community to live in. We have a great school district, and we have a great location. And those are things that we need to emphasize. We need to work together to attract businesses to locate here.
What are we gonna do to work to get, you know, the business, to grow the business community in Cottage Grove? There's a couple things, you know. The big thing is we need to streamline the process for businesses to come here. We need a focused review of the ordinances we have, where are the gaps, and what's redundant. In 2014, architectural review met twice, economic development met three times, ordinance review met once, CDA didn't even have members. This is not an effort put forward by a group that's focused on a goal. The most met committee in 2014 was the Deer Grove EMS. They met 15 times, not including special meetings for contract negotiations. The budget and run fees get talked about a lot every month in the board meetings, which is important. Budgets are important. Public works, utility budgets rarely ever get talked about. What are we doing to reduce the cost to serve Cottage Grove, to drive businesses to want to come here, showing that we are fiscally responsible in our community? Also, contracts need to be reviewed. Are we putting contracts out to bid so that local businesses can be part of the solution? An example, the Commerce Park was a contract that was also just renewed, wasn't put out to bid. The PD situation was also mentioned earlier, where a lot of the contracts were from outside of the area. Again, it's part of the process, but how do we reach out to the community and make sure that the local people are engaged and part of the process? So a little, I guess, the summary too, it's the last question. We need to work with the chamber to streamline the process for growth, focus on the goals, create them where there are none, bring back the promised transparency, rebuild the relationship with the town to grow the commerce and business so we can support our residential base. That's it.
Thanks. Three things really make up a great community. Residents, obviously, a great school district, we have that, and a great business community. And I'm a fan of all three. We have people that live here that are interested in buying local and being part of the local economy. Our school district, the support for our school district, in my opinion, is unmatched. You can go into any classroom and the vast majority of the sports paraphernalia that's being worn by those children is MG, it's not Packers. You'll have that, but it's mostly MG. We support our local school. I think that we are ready to do that with our business too. I think the most important thing that we've done is create the CDA and continue to make Cottage Grove an attractive place for people to come. We have all the pieces. We just need to move forward. And I'm, being a business owner myself, I know how important it is. So I will continue my work with that. It's always been my number one issue.
How will you work with the business community? I have a business here. I'm a member of the chamber. I sit on the chamber board. I'm very involved. I have and continue to switch all my business and personal accounts over to places in Cottage Grove. I'm the type of person that will drive by one Subway to get to Cottage Grove and eat instead because I know who it benefits. I work with all the local banks with my business, and when I found my house in Cottage Grove, I found home. And I found home for my own residents, my business, and I think it's important for kind of the second question here of
what's your priorities for the business, is to kind of start asking some questions and dig a little deeper and find out why people are asking me about Sun Prairie and Monona and the growth that's going on and why they're not mentioning Cottage Grove in those sentences. My goal is to kind of try to get an identity for Cottage Grove with something to sell. My real estate practice, I can only sell a location in a good school district so long. So, thank you.
So my experience with the Village is that it's very business friendly. Matt and Aaron and our consultants at Rudabush are our first line of contact, and they do a great job. About a year and a half ago, we directed as a board Matt to really emphasize economic development as part of his job duties. And to that end, we stole Aaron away from his company. He was about a quarter-time consultant in the past, and for the same budget, we were able to bring him on full-time. So we've really prioritized that as an emphasis on the work of the board and the work of the staff. And I think that what made me really pleased was when Steel came in. You know, this huge international corporation, they sat up here after the deal was done and just praised the environment that they were working with and how business friendly we were. And it was really affirming that we're in the right direction. We continue to think big picture. I sat on the Economic Development Committee with Steve, and I think we all felt that we were just meeting to meet and it didn't have a lot of teeth. And so we sort of disbanded that, and we did the research and planned the CDA, which is as planned, now gearing up. And I think as a village, it's been clear that we don't value bureaucracy over business. On the ordinance committee that I sit on, we tweaked the ordinances for signs, for example, so that it wasn't becoming a big hassle for businesses just to put out a sign, and we wanted to make sure it was business friendly. We've grown economically. We had a nice surge this year. We've got a tax valuation increase of around $9 million. Cummings Steel has talked about adding another $5 million in the next 2 to 5 years. We have the third lowest municipal tax mill rate in Dane County behind Shorewood and Rockdale. So we're in a really good place. Of course, the big thing this year was the police department, the new creation of the village-only department. And that had a tax repercussion, of course. It was a really hard decision. It really was. And I think that despite being a difficult one we put a lot of research into, it was the right one. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, well, I'll just take a minute to read John's statement, so I'm going to put my tie on. My name is John Williams. I have been a part of the Cottage Grove community for over 12 years. My wife and I moved here from the Janesville area looking for a place with a small town feel to raise our two young children. Over the years, I have become more involved in the community from coaching soccer, assisting with Girls on the Run events, volunteering at school, and leading the Lions Club as past president and veteran belly whistler at the community parades. Professionally, I am the head of sales and marketing team for a contract organization supporting the pharmaceutical industry. I have over 15 years of experience in business development and continuous improvement leader, and I'm looking to leverage these skills to boost economic development, build transparency in village board activities, engaging citizens, and demonstrating fiscal accountability. John, thanks you.
All right. So that concludes the informational portion. On behalf of the chamber, I want to thank all of you for coming. Thanks for your time. Thanks for putting thought into the answers. And thanks for being flexible with how we wanted the format to be. So real quick, after we conclude here today, there's going to be an opportunity to chat with any of the candidates, probably till about 1:30 or so. If you'd like to stay after and do a little bit of a meet and greet, that's available as well. New partnership that kind of came down. I'm not sure how many of you are familiar with the Hot to Trot run that's coming up in June, I believe. Paula Severson, everybody knows what I mean. she called me and we had a nice talk on the phone, and they're trying to go from a 5K to a 10K or add a 10K into the race this year. However, they're coming up short on volunteers, so I'm going to be sending out an email. If any of you know of yourselves or the people at your companies that have a passion for serving Cottage Grove and fitness. They're looking for a couple of bodies for that as well. They also are going to be helping us out a little bit with promoting Family Fun Night. The day of the race, they'll be supplying flyers in every racer's packet, which is nice. It's a good partnership for us. So, golf outing, you know, please, please, please consider a whole sponsor team, something like that. A lot of fun things going on there. They're doing a great job. Anything else? Anybody else? Real quick. Dave?
If anybody's suffering from a TBS deficiency, that stands for Turner Broadcasting System, the game tonight is on TBS. If you can't get it, we're more than welcome to see you at the bar. Game starts at 6:47. And, what, 6:30. I did order a platter from Subway. So I guess you enjoy Subway again.
I keep none of it.
It's not meant as a plug, but it works, doesn't it? So if you are coming, it would be nice to let us know ahead of time, but we're more than welcome to attend.
Thanks, Dave. All right, a couple thank yous. Thank you to Sherry for organizing this. She did a great job, so thank you very much. Thanks to the village for hosting. Thanks to Dwayne for providing us all with good food, healthy options, so it's great. Next meeting will be in April. I don't know when it is, but Thursday, last Thursday of the month, fourth Thursday of the month. So, yep.
I need to make a plug as well. We're doing our third Walk It Cottage Grove. Heartland Family Chiropractic promotes a walking competition for 4 weeks. If you guys want to be involved or have questions, grab me quick. But this year, all the proceeds are actually going to go to support Bryce Abbott, who is the kid in town who has childhood cancer. So it's really good for many reasons. You get healthy and it's a health race. So
the meeting next month is at Badger.
April 23rd.
Yeah. And it's going to be, we've invited Cash Roll Fireman, Mark Kudernoff, Lori Sanders with the rodeo, and now Paula Severson. I'll get in touch with her so that they can give us some more information on the upcoming.
Alright, thanks everybody for coming. Have a great weekend. Thank you very much. Appreciate your time.